This time I'm going to be making a simple paper tray. Now, to be honest, this project for me didn't need to look particularly nice. It just really needed to serve the function of storing all my stray pieces of paper, which I tend to accumulate at university. Although this certainly isn't my best looking project to date, if you do want to build this project yourself, there'll be free plans down in the description for you to take a look at. I have this 3mm birch plywood which I actually salvaged from some old furniture, so I think if I remove this dirty edge along here, it should work out quite nicely for the trays. Got those cut out now, and I'm able to see that in this direction the plywood is actually pretty rigid, but in the opposite direction there's still a bit of flex there. So to address that, I've milled up these little supports and I'm going to attach one to each side of the plywood. I could just glue those directly onto there and I think that would look all right, but to neaten it up just a little bit, I'm actually going to cut a rebate and I'll do that over at the table saw. And now I can simply pull away this extra material and use a chisel to clean it up. I just finished off all of these with a little decorative chamfer. If you have them, some really small pin nails would be much easier than all of these clamps. To attach the sides to the paper trays, I'm going to be using these dado joints. Now, if you don't have the means to cut these dado joints, then you could simply just use glue and screws. Now, it might not look quite as nice, but it's certainly an alternative if you need to. Going to cut the dados here at the table saw using the crosscut sled. Unfortunately, my table saw doesn't accept stacked dado cutters, so to cut down on the number of passes which I have to make with the blade, I'm going to join the two sides of the paper tray together. Just before I go ahead and glue this all up, I've got a few finishing touches to make. I'm making these little cutouts in the front of each tray, and of course that will help to remove the paper when you need it. And just to add a little bit of decoration to this paper tray, I've also cut a small curve on the top of the sides. I'm gluing these little wooden strips to the back of each tray, and that should stop any paper from sliding off the back. And this last strip goes on the underside of the bottom tray here at the front, and that acts as a third foot for the paper tray and prevents it from tipping forward. Before I glue it all together, I'm giving all the parts a quick sand. It's at this point you will probably want to apply a finish to your paper tray, as it's going to be a lot easier to do that now than it will be when it's all assembled. with the glue dry now, that pretty much wraps it up. Unfortunately, I don't actually have time to apply a finish to this. I just don't have enough time before I have to head back to university. But one thing which I thought would look quite nice is if the sides were painted, maybe a black, or if you're something like Steve Ramsey, a nice bright colour would certainly liven this project up a little bit. Welcome to my bedroom here at Loughborough University. I thought it'd be nice for you to get a look at the finished paper tray in its new home, and as you can see, it's already very much in use. As always, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video, and if you did, be sure to like, subscribe, comment, all of the usual crap. I hope to see you all again really soon, but until then, take care. Bye-bye.